Due to the graphic content and discussion, this program may not be suitable for some viewers. Viewer's discretion is advised. The views and opinions of this show are not necessarily those of this network, its affiliates, or supporters.
Coming up on The Lexi Show.
No, my ego is extremely fragile. That's why even walking up to a woman and introducing yourself, asking for a number, that takes a lot of heart. Because she might say, I don't like you. And that is a long walk back, Jack.
The Lexi Show starts now.
They understood it. They couldn't read it.
Because I wasn't happy about life.
I prayed.
Can't tell by the sound of your voice if you're really in love with
that love God and will love me the way God loves me.
And you are
the free spirit.
I'm blessed. I am blessed.
I hurt can't lie. A lot of people.
If I say to you, baby, I love you, then baby, I love you. Oh, and I do. Yes, I do.
Welcome to this edition of The Lexi Show. Now, ladies, now you men, you can watch if you want to. But this show, I've been wanting to do this show for a very long time. This is a show just for us ladies because we get an inside look as to how men think in relationships. Now, I am a single woman. And I'm in the dating game. Are you starting already? And I am in the dating game. These are some friends of mine, but these are helpful friends of mine. I'm going to tell you why in a second. With me today, if you've ever heard of the group Christopher, they are two members out of the three members. Christopher Surratt is not here today, but we have Christopher Reid right here. Say hello.
Hello.
I call him Doc Reid, but I really call him my friend. He's a good friend of mine. And then also have a great friend, Christopher McNeal. What's happening? He thinks he is so sexy. It is just over the top. But no, I brought them here, ladies, because, and men, again, you can watch, but I'd rather you leave. So that really means you're going to stay. You're going to just be defiant. I feel it. Guys play so many games. So many games. I'm just going to start off the rip. Just gonna start off the rip. This is a show, ladies, about how we can get into the mind of the male species, because sometimes, guys, you can be really, really stupid. Wow. I'm gonna say it, I'm gonna put it out there, because it's something that we all talk amongst ourselves. I mean, you have these beautiful, God-fearing women, and you guys mess it up every time. Now, you've been married for how long, Reid?
16 years.
I call him by his last name, Reid. I call him by his last name, McNeil. You're 16 years, So you know the ins and outs of it. You know about relationships, the whole thing. So I'll get to you in a minute.
All right.
But McNeil, you're in it with me. You're single.
Yes, ma'am.
You looking?
Not really.
What?
Not really.
You're not looking?
Not really.
Not right now?
Not right now.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious.
I got you. And so right now, you're just cool?
Pretty much.
Just cool doing you?
Pretty much.
Okay, I got you. I got you. Your swag is on a billion. I'm just gonna start off saying that. I don't know if you're trying to do it. I don't know if you're trying to do it for the camera, because you got the whole Hill Street Blues toothpick thing happening.
He does the toothpick thing. I mean, we did a music video. We had the toothpick in it. We have an online thing. We was doing toothpick.
It's just you.
Brand trademark.
Well, I told you why I do it.
Why?
But that's another show.
Okay. Yeah, we're going to move on. You have co-authored a book called The Forbidden Secrets of the Goody Box in two sentences. What does that mean? I know what it means. Forbidden Secrets of the Goody Box. Talk to me about that.
Well, it's just a way of saying to women that they hold all the power when it comes to relationships.
You need to look in that camera. You need to say it with a straight face.
Ladies, you hold all the power when it comes to relationships, but you don't realize that because you don't know, all right? Men want what you have, all right? But women don't know what that is, and they don't know how to pull back on what they have.
So, are you talking about sex?
No, it's not just sex, because Christians, you're not supposed to be, you know, engaging in dabbling in that, right? Because I know everybody out there is not, you know, anyway. So, yeah, no, we're talking about sometimes women can give a little bit too much. For example, lady walks up to a guy in church and says, Lord told me, you my husband.
The devil.
Is.
Stop.
A liar. Okay, so that's.
Wait, stop, because that's a lot.
That.
She says what?
You're my husband.
God told me in a dream, Michael visited me, okay, said, so-and-so Deacon Jenkins, all right,
yeah,
is your husband.
Who says that?
Well, some women have been known to say, and that's backwards. That's backwards.
It's not even the word.
Well, the thing is, men like to hunt. We like to hunt, right?
Absolutely.
Right. We like to hunt. And if you don't realize that, then you'll be pursuing men. Like in the book, we talk about there are four types of hunters. All right. Now, you got to get this, ladies. All right. Real quickly, the first type of hunter is a predator. Now, a predator is like a shark. Now, interesting thing about a shark is can sense a drop of blood in the ocean for like up to 2 miles. So what does that mean? Knows when you're weak and you're vulnerable, ladies. So when that joker come in, okay, he ain't gonna be playing a lot of games. Remember Jaws? He had theme music, you know, you heard the music, news time to get out the water. So when he come in, he's like dun 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 bam. Do what he gotta say, say what he gotta do, do what he gotta say what he gotta do. Yeah, switch that. Uh-huh. And he gonna get your goodie box and he gonna swim on to the next one, right? Now, the second type is a parasite. Now, if you know anything about a parasite, it jumps onto the host, and it holds on for dear life and sucks its nutrients from the host. So if the host moves to the right, it's gonna move to the right. Move to the left, gonna move to the left. All right, now I call this the baby boy syndrome. Why? Because he's gonna eat your food, drive your car, live in your house, spend your money, and use and abuse your goodie box, and he gonna ride his bicycle on to the next one. Yeah, mm-hmm. So then you got the ambusher, mm-hmm. The ambusher. The ambusher, Reverend, he is like a frog. Imagine a green frog on a green lily pad with green trees around him. Now he's just sitting there, just minding his own business. A fly comes around. This is the day, this is the day. Okay, ladies, no disrespect, you're the fly. So you flying around, he's just looking. Come on, get in there. Okay, then he gets you, your goodie box, and he hops to the next one because he's characterized by being patient and camouflage, so he can wait you out. You know what I'm saying? Now, sometimes he's one of the hardest ones to distinguish. Lastly, ladies, this is the kind you really want. This is the cowboy. Now, this cowboy, he's out, imagine that he's with on the range with all the other cowboys, and he says, you know what? I want a horse, Reverend. Right. I'm tired of walking. Everybody else got him a horse. I want one. I don't want just any kind of horse. Mm-mm. I want one of them beautiful black stallions, right? Right. So he gets his homeboy, and he said, let's go get a horse, all right? So he sees one out there in the wild, and he says, look, she's beautiful, ain't she? His buddy says, yeah, she sure is. So he gets that horse, and what does he do? He captures it. He loves that horse. He takes care of that horse. He nurtures it. They eat together, sleep together. Why? Because he had purpose in his mind. That's what he wanted. Like the Bible says, when a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing. So you got the four type, but unfortunately, ain't a lot of cowboys out here, okay?
Yeah, tell me about it. You know, let's do this, because I'm not going to say that Chris has helped me a few times. He's helped me a few times. I'll just say it. I'll give you the credit. You know, I don't like to give that out there because my swag is on a billion.
It is. You have a billion
say it.
Swag.
Yeah.
Her swag is, Lexi's one of a kind. She's a different
Thank
type
you.
Of young lady.
Thank yeah. you. It is on a billion. But, you know, I do get your help. You know, if I'm going out on a date, you know, I will call him because he's the man. Ladies, if you want to, he specializes in the step-by-step process, the step-by-step program. I mean, I can literally call him and say, okay, he did this, he said this, what should I do? How should I counter that? Because I'm actually finding out what of the four types of what, predators?
Hunters.
I said predators. Four types of hunters that this guy falls in. Now, usually, I'm not saying that I'm completely, you know, that I don't know. I mean, I know men a lot, but you, being a man, you know you're going to get your man card snatched.
Well, no, not so much.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not making the guys look bad. You know, I'm just, really, I'm helping guys because really, we want it to be more exciting. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, a guy may take the low-hanging fruit, but we're not looking for not the woman that we really ultimately want to spend the rest of our life with, because we're not looking for the woman that we can live with. We're looking for the one we can't live without. So we want the one that's going to make us stretch our legs and chase.
Wrong. And let me tell you why. Let me tell you why. Why is it, ladies, I'm about to ask all the questions that you ever wanted to know about men. Why is it that you guys will sweat? I'm just going to use me as an example. Why do you sweat me for my number? Why do you sweat me for my number? And then you don't call for 3 days. What is that? Is that a game, Chris?
It's, we hunt.
And what?
We hunt. I mean, we go after, we see something we like, we approach it, say, can I have what you have? Or can I have what I like about you? And you say, and so you find, right, and so you finally, we wear you down, because that's what hunters do. We wear you down, we get what it is we wanted. Now, because we don't want to appear thirsty,
OMG.
We don't call you. Yes. It's not that we don't want to call you.
It's stupid.
It is stupid.
It's stupid.
Because I see something I want, right?
Right.
I've apprehended it in a sense. But then not to call would mean that it's sending a mixed signal to you, because you're like, okay, you sweating me for my number. Why didn't you call me, dude? Right. He really wants to call you. I really want to call you. I really want to be in touch with you, but I don't want to lose the image that you may have, or the image I may have of myself.
Wow.
So I don't call you. And that third day, I was busy. I was into this, I was into that. Anyway, I wasn't doing nothing. I was just waiting it out so I could appear away to you.
So it's a lie.
Pretty much.
It's a game.
Smoke and mirrors.
Yeah.
It's a game.
It is. It is.
This is what I've experienced, and ladies, I know that you've experienced this too, is that men will chase. I've had men chase me down. And then when I say, when I give in, and you know this, you try to act like you don't know this, you too. And when I give in and we're going out and all this, all of a sudden they stop, they call less. The dates aren't as frequent. The whole swag on the phone is a little different. Now you're posturing more. Yeah, what's up? At first it was, hey, how you doing? Now it's like, hey, what's up? Listen, all right, let me call you back real quick. Really? And then I got to now I have to play the game because I'm salty. So now, I have to just sit back and go, okay. Now I have to look at you when you call and send you behind the voicemail. Huh?
A lot of women won't do that.
Then you can talk to the lady. You have reached. Now you have to do that because now you're playing a game. Are you playing a game? Is this a game? Or you just getting lax, like, okay, I have her now, and you don't have to try so hard. But now that makes me think a way about you, because we're not married. And so if this is the best of you, I don't want you. I don't want the rest of you. Ooh, if yeah, this ooh. Is the best of yeah. you, I don't want the rest of you. That's a book.
Yeah, I was right copyright on that.
So what's up with that? Seriously, Reid.
Yeah, a lot of time, because we're goal-oriented. All right, we're driven, and once we get you, then, okay, you're cool, we're together. So now I feel as if I can focus on whatever else, whether that's work or, like I said, we're very, got to make it happen. So when our woman tells us, you're not doing this, how come you're not doing that, we're thinking, what's the problem? That's oftentimes we'll get lax and we'll just go to Valentine's Day and the certain days that anniversaries, we know we're supposed to give you things. But that's when you have to educate the guy. We talk about love.
Then we sound like nagging.
Well, yes, you may sound like it.
Education, educate the guy, but that sounds like nagging. Like
it could if he's not knowledgeable about like the five love languages. Yeah. Like say, for example, if yours is words of affirmation, you like to hear, oh, I love you, I miss you.
That's
you just
me.
Want, yeah, you want him
I
to tell
to
you
hear.
That all the time.
Okay.
You may think.
I like the day
yeah,
pumpkin.
Yeah, yeah, he
it's
said
cute.
Something crazy. Okay, he may think, okay, why should I have to tell you so much? Or I told you yesterday, and you still saying you don't miss me and all this today. Well, you need to hear it all the time.
That's
and
neat.
He may think it's over the top. It's not over the top. It's just your love language.
Name the other languages? It's words of affirmation.
Quality time.
Acts of service.
Mm-hmm.
Gift giving.
Physical touch.
Okay. I like words of affirmation. I'm not big on gifts. You don't have to give me gifts. You don't have to do all that. That's nice, but I don't require that. I can get my own. But I have to have words of affirmation. And I like them a lot. And I like them every day. Is that wrong?
That's the heart of the matter.
What?
That's the heart of the matter. She's giving. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
What? No,
forgive
go ahead.
Me.
Totally.
It's because beyond all the swag, beyond all of the charisma, beyond all of the accomplishments, and you walking in and changing the vibe of a room and all of that foolishness, that's who you are. You need that. You can't go a day without words of affirmation. If a dude does not know that and is willing to cater to that, it's a wrap. Because he doesn't speak your language. You're speaking Hebrew, he's speaking French. And a dude, you can always tell if a dude is really into you, if he knows what your love language is and is selfless enough to give himself over to it.
Or try to, but it ain't gonna happen overnight.
It's not gonna happen overnight.
You know, the change will take some time, and that's the challenge for the woman. You have to be patient. Okay.
I don't listen,
Reverend. I know you can't have it. This ain't microwave love. Okay. He didn't get that way. Especially if a guy tells you, I know I'm not wired like this, but I want to be this way for you. Right. I mean, if a guy is vulnerable enough and transparent enough to tell you that, then I think you owe it to him to at least give him time to grow into that. Now, after a certain amount of time, if it doesn't seem like anything is changing, then, you know, you may have a decision to make. Maybe this is not, you know, what he's saying and what he's doing is two different things, but I wouldn't just cut him loose just right off the bat.
Speaking of saying and doing two different things, why do men have problems with titles? What's wrong with saying we're together? What's wrong with saying you're my woman? What's wrong? Nobody's doing that anymore. That's sixth grade. All of a sudden, that's sixth grade now. We can't call a woman a girlfriend. Is that a problem? We're too old for that now. So we go straight from dating to wife?
It could represent something else. See, titles, in a way, represent
commitment.
Yeah. But not only that.
I'm getting angry.
Yeah, you are. Titles represent the end of something. It's just like marriage and dating. When some dudes, when they get into marriage, I know dudes that are gung-ho about getting married. They cannot wait to do it. But then I know some dudes that's like, miss me with all that, son. I'm good. Because marriage represents the end of an era for them. It represents the end of being able to call her, 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 and her. It represents the...
OMG, that is like the emptiest thing ever. So you just gonna miss the party train that you're on? I mean, the party train is so important. You know, this woman, that woman. When does it get old?
When he wants something more than that.
Yeah, because it really stems from a dissatisfaction inwardly. It's an inequity inside the man. That's why he has to have so many women. It's something that he hasn't dealt with in himself. And so because he doesn't know him, how can he know how to treat you? Like, a part of him is sporadic. A part of him is nice. A part of him is giving. A part of him is creative. Now, he hasn't put all of this together to make one dude, so he feels like he needs a woman to represent each part of him. So he's going to you, talking to her, talking to her, talking to her, and he's trying to manage it all because he's not satisfied inwardly. So you got, Lex, what's up, baby? Yo, let me call you right back. And then he calling her. I got you in about 10 minutes, boo. I got you.
A lot of times a guy will chase and he'll be right there at the breaking point. I mean, meaning he'll be ready to be all in, and he may even pull back a little bit, and the woman may feel a sense of desperation and start pressing in on him. Well, his intensity might go down. But if she just holds off and still lets him come to her, then he'll break through and say, okay, I want you enough to forsake all others. Titles, I mean, have you ever seen a situation where a guy, he got real cool on you? And then you said, oh,
listen.
Okay, this is what we're doing?
Oh, my.
In 2011?
And if you're watching right now, you done got me upset.
Yeah, I'm so mad right now. But, you know, somehow from Ohio, you got some wisdom.
What?
On how to handle the situation.
And I did
and
what?
Then you got some wisdom on how to handle
and
it.
And I gave him what? Two fingers.
Okay. And then did you see a breaking in
what?
The spirit? Did you see something?
I couldn't see because I was gone. My back was to the situation. So you can't see what when you're gone.
Did he pursue?
Huh?
Did he pursue?
Did he what?
Uh-huh.
Is he pursuing right now?
Okay.
Huh?
He didn't care about no titles, did he?
No.
No.
Want to give me a title right now?
Mm-hmm.
Do I want it?
I'm sorry.
Mm-mm. You had your window of time and opportunity.
I love this. I love it. You know what? It is my passion, especially with women. It's even like
I'm upset.
Successful women. You got a question in there about successful women?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why can't y'all handle successful women?
I can handle it.
Well, you have a successful wife. You've been married for 16 years. Why can't you handle successful women? What's the problem?
Intimidation.
What are you intimidated by? If I love you, if I care about you, why is that intimidating?
Maybe I don't love me enough to let you love me in your success. I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to handle a woman that makes six figures or more. I don't know how to handle a woman who drives a, or who has herself driven around in a Maybach, who lives as wonderfully as she wants to. I don't know how to handle that. I've never had to. So I've reverted to the hoodies, the hood rats, and no disrespect.
Is that true?
Absolutely.
So whoa, so you can't date a woman that makes six figures? You can't? You?
Chris McNeal. At this point in his life, I'm not there yet.
What?
Not right now. I'm making my way up.
Is that too much honesty, Reverend?
So let's just put it out there. Let's say if I dug you, you're attracted to me, I'm attracted to you. I do my thing, I have a job, you know, whatever. I'm making a fairly decent amount of money or whatever. And I give, you know, I'm giving it to you. I'm giving you the, you know, all the hints, the signs. You would not date me?
If I'm real,
I'm not driving a Maybach, but I'm just saying.
If I'm real with myself, at this time, probably not.
So you would pass? Why?
Because I don't know how to do it.
What would you, all you have to do is just, I don't get it. All you have to do is just be loving and accept the love that I give. I don't understand why that's so difficult.
But then I have to be secure enough to know. I have to be secure enough in myself to not be jealous, to not be envious even. I have to be secure in myself to not let my emotions get the best of me. If I see another dude talking to you, I mean, you're attractive, you are very well spoken, you're intelligent, you have gray head on your shoulders. I mean, you walk like one of them stallions that we were talking about. That's why I laughed when you said it. I don't know how to handle a pure thoroughbred. I would love to know how to handle one because I think I'm a thoroughbred kind of guy. But at the same time, nobody's ever coached me. Nobody's ever done that for me.
I'll coach you, Reverend.
I mean, you coach me all the time. I mean, we've been friends 20 years, man. So you've walked with me through divorce. You've walked with me through, you know, different women that I dug. You've walked me through the whole thing. But at the same time, you would always say to me, dude, you can have anybody from Beyonce to Angela Bassett to everybody in between. But you got to believe that. Those were your words to me.
Yes, they were.
So I think in some way, you've always, the seed has been planted. But I don't know if I've ever watered it enough so it can increase. And, you know, I don't have a problem being friends with women who are successful. I have plenty of successful friends. Plenty. They make plenty of money. But as for being in relationship with them, I don't know if I could do it.
We need to be needed, okay? And at some point, if there's some type of clashing, or if we feel like somehow there's no place for me here or space for me here, because I've heard women say, why would he leave this good girl and go to the hood rat?
Right.
You know, the hood rat, I show up and I'm a hero. And I don't mean no disrespect. I don't mean disrespect the hood rat. Somebody else said that in the questions. I love everybody. But I'm
just calling like you see it.
But I'm just saying that as soon as I show up, I can show up with a McDonald's bag. And I am Superman. Now, over here, you make 30,000 figures a year, and I show up with this, and you like, excuse me, are you serious?
That's not true.
I just thought maybe he was hungry. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying.
You guys are so stupid, because you're missing out on good women.
No, listen, think about this, okay?
Oh, my God.
God made roles in the very beginning. Okay, let's just take it back, bones and whatever. We go out with the arrow, we shoot the thing, Women ain't out there with us side by side shooting, so this is what we do out here, all right? So we bring the thing back, and we proud. I killed this for my family, and I bring it and I lay it at your feet. Now, you're going to do with it what God ordained you to do, all right? And everybody got their roles, the kids, everybody's happy, nobody's stepping on toes, I'm good. Now, in this day and age,
you out there shooting with your arrow. And look, I'm looking at you, I'm like this with mine. Your arrow is like, you know, you pushing it and it's long, and I'm like, I'm gonna go over here and shoot because I don't like, you know what I mean?
Right.
So now I got to deal with the ego of your big old bow. I don't, you know, so I'm just saying that I know it's not gonna go revert back, but we, because things are different, we have to adjust.
Adjust.
And it's from your perspective, hey, it's easy. I don't see what the big deal is. Mi casa, su casa. But for us as men, there's some adjustment that has to happen because McNeal has said something. We had done a DVD. I did a DVD called Why He Married Her Instead of You. And I interviewed different guys. McNeal is one of the guys on there. He said something very profound on there about, can she handle my
vulnerability?
Yeah, say that, what you said.
The question was, if I give you my vulnerability, can you handle it? Do you know what to do with it? And I guess I'm asking them through you.
Because you were talking about respect.
Right.
Because, you know, when you talk about the respect and she's powerful and she's in the boardroom and she's doing it big, a guy still needs to feel that certain level of respect, regardless.
And okay. Oftentimes a guy, love is translated respect.
Are you afraid that if you date someone that's making all these, you know, $200,000 or something, you know, a woman that's making that much money, would you be concerned that maybe she wouldn't respect you, or, you know, and not be vulnerable? In other words, there are some women, Chris, that can actually leave it at the door. I'm one of them. You know, you do what you do out there. I don't care what it is. But when you hit that door, you're no longer the boss. You're no longer the producer. You're no longer the host. You know, you're a woman that wants a man. And do you feel like most women can't check it at the door? Because a lot of women can't.
I feel like it's more me than them.
Okay.
It's not. It really has less to do with you all. It has more to do with me.
Okay. Okay. Well, I will say that a lot of women can't leave it at the door. I will say that. Let me ask you this. Why do men lie about little stuff that doesn't even matter? Just lie.
Sometimes just don't want to deal with hearing a bunch of questions about it. One of the guys on the DVD said, you asked me, you know, what time did you get home last night? I don't know, 8. He said, and she said, well, no, you didn't. You got home at 7. Well, if you knew, why'd you ask me?
Wow, classic man response. And yeah, that doesn't
you know,
sit well.
You know, he's like, I didn't want to go through explaining. I stopped at the store and then I went
it's
over
too much
to Johnny's
you?
House. And
it's just
easier.
Yeah.
Yep, 8.
Wow.
I mean, I'm not saying it's right. You ask why, you know. Sometimes it's the path of least resistance. And sometimes it's just lying just to be lying. Liars. You know, I mean, you ain't got to be no Einstein. He lies, baby. He lies.
Next week on The Lexi Show.
No, my ego is extremely fragile. That's why even walking up to a woman and introducing yourself, asking for a number, that takes a lot of heart. Because she might say, I don't like you. And that is a long walk back, Jack.
Like us on Facebook by searching for The Lexi Show.